Mario Iacobelli was born on September 11, 1938, at home in Detroit. Raised with priorities like faith and family, he was one of three children and was never afraid of a day's work.
He took risks that typically most people would fear to take and were uncomfortable with.
Mario built a construction business from the ground up with his family.
My father started his career with his brother-in-law, and his father. It was always a family-based business.
Soon, Bill Kring became part of that family, too.
He and I both had the same philosophy, is that we don't have to win, but we hate to lose.
It wasn't long before the tools changed, from cranes to cameras, excavators to editors. But it wasn't the smoothest career transition.
I remember the battle to get the station. And I remember my dad was not giving up.
Well, it set precedence, yeah. Yeah, it's on specific performance. It went to appellate court, and it was going to go before the Supreme Court of Michigan. But it was settled, and it was specific performance.
As Mario took ownership of WWTV, WWUP, the broadcasting industry had already learned something intrinsic to his character.
So the one thing about Mario is that if you make a handshake and you make a deal, and your word is gold, and if you give your word, you uphold your word. And the people he was buying from broke their word. And that's one of the things that Mario does not accept.
And from the day he walked in, Mario had a vision. This was taken from an interview in 2004.
A person watching our news should have no difference if he watches our news today and drives to Detroit tonight. He should see the same quality, the same commitment. Everything should be the same. And that's what we've done. We've striven for it. So I'm very pleased with where we're at.
I'd been here for 10 years before he bought the station, and it was all hand-typed, done everything, no computers. Things were not fixed properly in the years prior to him buying the station. So, as he put it, it was put together with rubber bands and paper clips, and they fixed all that when Mario bought it.
Longtime station employees like Sherry Magera were unsure what the new ownership would bring.
I think everybody was a little nervous, not knowing, you know, what it was going to be like. And he's a real person. He's not just a person that's down in Detroit and running the place from down there. He's here all the time.
And through those relationships, that dedication, and the investment, Mario brings the best out of the people who work for him.
And I think that's important to Mario, that if he's going to own a TV station, that TV station do all the right things. And he's going to find the people and give them the resources to do a good job, because, you know, he wants to do a job that he can be proud of, and we all want to do a good job to make Mario proud.
That giving spirit and loyalty extends beyond the station, making friends and making his mark across northern Michigan.
Well, we became very good friends, and he did a lot for me for our little restaurant in this corner of town. And his integrity and his word is awesome. Also, he's very knowledgeable about wine, and I catered his daughter's wedding, and we shared so many good bottles together. I mean, in great discussions, and I learned a lot from the man, okay? I learned a lot.
In the time that Mario's been in Cadillac, the station has been very important to our community, and Mario's leadership has really helped to put Cadillac on the map.
Even if you just met him, you'd feel as though you'd known Mario for a lifetime. The successes of his career are only rivaled by the skills of his golf game, and I can guarantee both are worthy of recognition.
He's not a man of many words.
He picks and chooses his times to speak, and he did that when I was a kid. You know, like, that was my lessons of, you know, you go for a drive with your dad for somebody, you may not say two words, but I guarantee those two words that you heard were like, wow. Gotta learn something from those.
My dad is a great listener, and the quietness is sometimes him listening. Other times, it's used as a strategy in a negotiation.
He's a man of quality statements, and I have a notebook that carries all of those quality statements in it.
And you certainly don't want to get on his bad side.
Just a little known fact, kind of unique, that I am the only person in the history of people doing business with Mario that was banned, that was taken off the ban list. He's a good man, super good man.
A good man who will do anything for those who've earned his respect and proven their loyalty.
He's the most caring individual I've ever met. You know, if you need something, he's there to give it to you.
He takes care of his employees like he takes care of a family.
I've never met a person in my life as great as Mario.
For those who've worked, played, and laughed alongside Mario, there is no one as deserving as he is to be recognized for a lifetime of achievement.
Hey, congratulations, Mario. You're the best. You deserve it. We love you. We all love you here.
Congratulations, Mario, on a lifetime achievement award. I can't think of a more deserving person.
Congratulations, Mario. A lifetime achievement award. It signifies that you've been active in your community.
You're the best boss that I ever had and a great friend as well. When it mattered the most, you knew how to treat me with dignity and respect, but we always wrapped up every collaboration that we had with a big belly laugh and a big smile. Congrats to you, Mario. I miss you. Take care.
Mario, your commitment to news in Northern Michigan is unparalleled, and I offer my sincerest gratitude for your service. Congratulations on this great honor.
I just think it's a testament to him, and I think it's something long overdue.
Congratulations, boss. Look forward to the next 26.
Dad, congratulations. I'm so proud of you, and I'm happy to be here.
It's great to have been a part of the organization that you've built, and I'm proud of you. Love you.
Folks that have been watching us for the last 50 years continue to watch us for the next 50 years. It's been great. And I enjoy being here. Thank you.